Let's set the injection molding pressure, which is one of the equipment constraints in the injection molding process. When injecting resin from the injection molding machine into the mold, we must take into account the injection molding pressure. There is a permissible range of pressure that the mold can resist, and exceeding this range will cause mold failure. Moreover, excessive injection pressure will cause a gap in the mold, producing burrs. The magnitude of the injection pressure is determined individually for each molded part. When manufacturing component 1, injection pressure of 50 tons is required. For component 2, injection pressure of 200 tons is required. Next, let's set the permissible range of injection pressure for the injection molding machines. The injection pressure can be constrained by setting a maximum value and a minimum value for injection pressure min and max of the injection molding machine. This injection molding machine can inject resin at a pressure of 50 tons or lower. Let's reschedule. As component 2 cannot be manufactured with the registered injection molding machine, it was assigned to a dummy resource. Therefore, we will add injection molding machines capable of manufacturing component 2. We add 3 injection molding machines, injection 1 to injection 3, to the resource table. And we set injection to the resource group. Resource group injection is registered to the integrated master. During rescheduling, assignment is done to any of registered injection 1 to 3 registered to resource group injection. In this way, the number of injection molding machines can be increased while keeping the current integrated master as is. Now, let's set the permissible range of injection pressure for each injection molding machine. For injection 1, we will set 0 tons to 50 tons. For injection 2, 40 tons to 100 tons, and for injection 3, 80 tons to 200 tons. Let's reschedule and check which molded part can be manufactured by which equipment. The injection pressure value for component 1 being 50, component 1 was assigned to injection 1. It can also be manufactured by injection 2. The injection pressure value for component 2 being 200, component 2 was assigned to injection 3. It cannot be manufactured by other injection molding machines because it exceeds their upper injection pressure limit. Let's see whether we can shift this operation to another injection molding machine. The no entry mark is displayed for the other injection molding machines, so this operation cannot be shifted. In this way, it is possible to prevent at the planning stage any plans or instructions that would result in the upper injection pressure limit being exceeded.